Hi, I'm Dr. Sheela B S. I'm an obstetrician and gynecologist. I'm practicing at Dr. Sheela Women's Wellness Clinic situated in RR Nagar, Bangalore. Menopause usually occurs between age of 40 and 50 years. But if it happens before the age of 40, then it's called premature menopause. What are the incidences? It is rare, definitely. So, 1 in 1,000 between the age of 15 and 29 years, and 1 in 100 between the age of 30 and 39 years. So, it's a rare condition, but it's still possible. What causes this kind of premature menopause? The most commonest cause is premature ovarian failure. Next comes the surgical removal of the ovaries for different indications. And the third, nowadays there is increasing concern regarding the rise in cancer conditions, especially the ovaries and the uterus. See, increasing incidence of the cancers leading to chemotherapy, exposure of the woman to the chemotherapy and radiotherapy, and definitely the damage done to the ovaries. Next comes the autoimmune disorders, genetic conditions, thyroid disorders, chronic diseases, hypothalamic and pituitary disorders or dysfunctions, psychiatric disturbances. So there are many more conditions which leads to premature ovarian failure. So these are the women with premature menopausal condition. She will experience all the menopausal symptoms like hot flushes, night sweats, weight gain, irritability, mood swings, and sexually there is a low drive in the sex, that is decreased libido, dryness in the vagina, eyes, mouth, and she also experiences palpitation, and psychological problems are quite high here. To diagnose this particular condition, special tests are not required because the woman is already experiencing all the symptoms of menopause. One test which can be done is to assess the FSH level in the blood. It will be more than 40 milli international units, and estradiol level in the blood will be less than 30 picogram. So this will confirm that the woman is suffering from premature menopause. It's also important to note that there is no treatment which can improve or reverse this particular condition. So based on the cause for this premature menopause, like premature ovarian failure, there's a gradual decrease in the secretion of estradiol. So the patient experienced the gradual increase in her menopausal symptoms. So it's a gradual process. Whereas in case of surgical removal of the ovary, the woman experiences abruptly the menopausal symptoms, because once the ovaries are removed, there is abrupt stoppage in the release of estradiol. Also in condition like patient exposed to the chemotherapy or radiotherapy in cancer patients. So based on the reason for particular condition, premature menopause, the symptoms will vary. As I've already told you, no treatment is available which will either reverse or prevent premature ovarian failure. But still, we have to manage these patients. In premature ovarian failure patients, there is no ovulation happening because the level of estrogen is very low and the FSH level is very high. So these patients, the main concern is not only the menopausal symptoms creating problems for them, but the infertility is a major issue. So since they cannot have their own babies, one can either go for adoption or they can take a donor egg and go for IVF procedures. Now, a person who is going through the cancers, having a cancer, and they have to go through the chemotherapy or radiotherapy, the ovaries can be removed and grafted at different place so that they can be used for later fertility issues. Before the exposure to chemotherapy and radiotherapy, this can be done. Or even the egg can be retrieved and kept in IVF center so they can be fertilized later date after the marriage or whenever they want pregnancy. Hormone replacement therapy is one very important method in all these patients irrespective of the reason for their premature menopause, in order to avoid the symptoms which are very, very discomfortable for a woman, especially the hot flushes. And not only the symptoms, it also can help in reducing the complications of this ovarian failure leading to osteoporosis as well as cardiac problems. So HRT is one important method where we can use estrogen in the form of tablets. It can be given in the form of patches, and also vaginal rings are available now which releases the estrogen on a daily basis. So, but patient has to be monitored, and the patient is on HRT, she has to be regularly monitored with blood investigations and also look for any, this can sometimes lead to endometrial cancers and breast cancers, so they need to be under supervision. Thank you.